That prologue.
Dr. Henry Armitage pours himself a glass of Pinot Noir and sits down at his desk, gesturing for you to sit across from him. I apologize for short notice, he begins. His face is pale, his forehead sweaty and wrinkled with worry. Armitage, the head librarian of Miskatonic University and a former mentor of yours, privately contacted you in the hopes of gaining your assistance. Eager to help, you made your way to his home in Southside. Upon entering, you were surprised to find his home in disarray. Books and notes litter his desk, and an empty bottle of wine has tipped over onto the ground by the fireplace.
Oh, shit.
You'd always known Armitage to be neat and well-organized.
And not an alcoholic, and yeah. Now I started drinking again.
Again?
Yeah.
The elderly man takes a moment to collect his thoughts. I am looking for two of my colleagues, Dr. Francis Morgan, Professor of Archaeology, and Warren Rice, Professor of Languages. Warren was supposed to meet up with me over supper earlier today to discuss several important findings, but he has since gone missing. At first I thought nothing of it, but I have a nagging feeling that something else is going on. A very familiar feeling. You've never seen Armitage quite this worried before. His hands tremble as he reaches for the glass on his desk and sips from it nervously. I tried to find Francis, hoping he knew where Warren was, but he too is out of touch. Francis has been spending a lot of time in some gambling den, or so I am told. I sent for you because I am worried Warren might be in trouble. I would appreciate it greatly if you could find him for me. You may also wish to ask Francis for help if you can reach him. And we decided beforehand we're going to do scenario 1B first. The host always wins because that's what our two drifters would do.
Yes. This is accurate. Also, as a side note, Chad, how's it going? Binary Cupcakes, thank you so much for the host. And no, this is not magic. And also one thing, Travis, why don't you bump your mic up a little tiny bit more? Cool. Yeah, certainly the house always wins.
Dr. Armitage suggests you track down his associate, Dr. Francis Morgan. He's not sure whether Dr. Morgan is in trouble, but he's not particularly happy with his colleague's present choice of company. He's in the Clover Club, a notorious gambling joint somewhere downtown. Finding the club's exact location isn't easy. You have to grease a few palms just to learn which of the downtown restaurants operates as the club's front. That restaurant is La Bella Luna, a somewhat upscale Italian eatery by the theater. You change into your Sunday best, which is still just like garbage clothes.
Hey, I'm a drifter. So are you.
Make your way there. At least she's rich.
It's true. She's a rich drifter? Such a thing exists?
The front of La Bella Luna stands a man in a pinstripe suit who sizes you up as you approach. Enjoy yourselves, he says with a snake-like grin as he holds open the restaurant's front door.
Just for reference, I'm playing Wonderwall on my guitar. Just over and over and over again. It's the only thing I know. Just so everybody knows.
Okay. I'm so happy I'm going with Bryn, not you.
Yeah.
Can I read these out?
Yeah, sure. Good ones first.
Yeah, sure.
You need to find Dr. Morgan. The club is packed. Perhaps somebody knows where he is. When you reveal a chaos token, you may treat the token as if it were any other token in the chaos bag. If you do, remember that you have cheated. Group limit once per round. Objective.
That's good.
Objective. When the investigators have collected the requisite number of clues, they must immediately spend them in advance. So 4 per investigator.
That's a lot.
No problem.
You have entered the Clover Club Casino in search of Dr. Morgan. The club is bustling at this late hour, filled with patrons looking to relax or drink or make it big. You don't appear to be in much danger. Each criminal enemy gains aloof and forced. If an investigator deals damage to a criminal enemy, immediately advance.
Okay.
Okay.
So if we had dynamite,
we could just
blow this guy up.
See ya! So the location we're on is La Bella Luna. La Bella Luna was a multi-purpose establishment. Now I flip it now, right?
Yeah, because that's where we are.
Resign. This was a bust. Two shadow. It has 4 clues on it.
3 clues.
Fuck this.
Yeah, sorry. I keep thinking Patrick's here. The music is cliche and they only serve spaghetti. What's wrong with that? As far as covers for underground speakeasies go, it's not particularly creative.
Want to go over who we're playing?
Yes, I would love to. I am Ashcan Pete the Drifter. I begin the game with Duke, my cute dog. Everyone likes him, and he's really friendly. I may discard a card from my hand to ready an asset I control once per round. And whenever I draw the Elder Sign symbol, which I never will, I get +2, and I ready Duke. Duke has the ability to exhaust him for a fight, and he has a base attack of 4, and it deals +1 damage. And I can exhaust Duke to investigate. You investigate with a base skill of 4, and I may move to a connecting location immediately before using this effect. So that seems pretty strong.
All right. I'm Jenny Barnes, also a drifter, but like much wealthier. I collect one additional resource during each upkeep, and my Elder Sign effect is I gain plus one for each resource I have.
Really notable thing about Jenny is that she has three in all of her stats, so she's not bad at anything.
Yep.
I'm playing Rex Murphy, the reporter. After I succeed at a skill test by two or more while investigating, I can discover one clue at my location. And as a star effect, I get plus two. I may instead choose to automatically fail the skill test to draw three cards.
Who's Duke is my cute dog. Look, he's cute.
Yeah, it's Ash Camp Pete's dog.
Everyone loves Duke the dog. You can eat him in the other game to gain back sanity.
Because that's insane, people. Dude.
Like, not even some sanity, but like all of it.
Just all of it.
Who should our first player be?
Maybe it's actually like a shock. You're just like...
Best draw in terms of for us.
Sure.
Best first player.
Yeah, whoever draws, like, whoever's most likely to succeed their test.
Sure, I like this. Keep it hidden in your palm. I guess then reveal it.
No, I just wanted to see Bryn flip the red one.
Oh yeah,
I mean, like, this was gonna happen, so.
All right, everyone get palm in the center. Ooh, Bryn!
Damn. Justin, you want to spend two resources?
Oh, turn it into a zero. Please.
Could pull the team to go first.
All right, well, I'm the lead investigator now.
Yeah, okay.
It's over for you.
Resign.
Fuck this, I'm out. I don't want to play anymore. I'll go do something else. Sit on your couch and watch TV.
Wait for Patrick to get home.
Mm-hmm.
All right, so this is a Shadow of Two. That's what this is called, right? Shadow?
Shroud.
Shroud, yeah.
All right, well, I'm going to...
Cannot target. Dust.
I'm going to draw a card.
Nice.
Cool. I'm going to draw a card. Also cool. Do I get money for the first turn?
At the end of it.
At the end of it? Okay. I'm going to play...
Because we start during phase two.
Hard knocks. So I can spend one money for plus one fight on a skill test or spend one money for plus one fight on a skill test.
Seems good.
That's what I got.
Hey, are we just going clockwise unless it's relevant?
Yeah, I think so.
Okay. Play Magnifying Glass for fast action.
Nice.
So not in action. We'll let my rabbit's foot for tick one. Draw a card for two. Draw another card for three. Oh, good, I drew my curse. So nice. Whenever I would succeed at a skill test, I return the revealed token to the bag and reveal a new one. If this effect causes me to fail the test, I shuffle the curse back into my deck. Limit once per test, so I can't just... That'd be pretty brutal if it was just like, keep drawing until you lose.
I don't have any of the new card games for Call of Cthulhu. I have most of the older ones. That's cool. This is their newest one from it. It's pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
So if there's one thing I know about Ash Can Pete is that his weakness requires him to discard all but one card in his hand. So I'm just going to start putting up my baseball bat.
And they, like, let this dirty drifter into the club, and he can just let his dog in. He walks, he just pulls out his baseball bat, and we're like, oh my god.
I'm also going to grab pickpocketing to get that on standby.
Getting kicked out. Getting ready to, like, pick some guy's pocket. Like,
and
Can Pete, please.
I'm going to steal this, and I need this.
I'm going to use Duke to investigate on this area.
That's fair.
Just because, yeah. So I have an investigation skill of 4 to this 2, and Duke... passes, because with a tie you pass. Thanks, Duke. Already a good dog.
I want Wilbur Whately. That sounds like a bad time.
I want Wilbur. End of round, enemy phase. Does this guy have the hunter keyword? So prey.
He's also got like aloof though. Yeah.
He does, but just he does have the hunter keyword and aloof. Aloof means they just don't do anything. They ignore us, right?
He might move to us, but I think he doesn't. He doesn't like engage anyone.
He doesn't have hunter, or he does have hunter.
Yeah,
okay.
He might hunt, but I don't think he,
Yeah, when it, just ignores people.
Okay.
Just so everyone knows, this guy is a criminal elite. He has a strength of 3, an evade skill of 3, and 4 health. His prey is the highest book, so he's coming after this guy.
Yep.
Or Duke. After investigator Clover Club pit boss's location gains any number of clues, he readies, engages that investigator, and makes an immediate attack, and he deals 2 physical damage.
He's like way more makes way more sense for him to be after Duke. He's like, who let this dog into my club?
What the fuck is going on here?
All right, so now we go to the upkeep phase. Preset actions.
Sorry, it's been a while since we played this. I'm going to take us a round or two.
Ready all exhausted cards.
Get yourself
a Each investor draws a card and gains a resource.
Doom on the agenda.
Ooh, there's something in the drinks. Surge, revelation, each player who has had a drink loses an action. There, no drinks have been had. I'll take another card though, please.
Oh, because it has surge?
Yeah. Sorry, you should get this one then. That one also has surge because there's no criminals that can fight us, I believe.
Hey, Enid Coleslaw, how's it going? I guess I could call you Julie, but I'm not going
to
do that.
I mean, like, there's an unengaged criminal. If there are no unengaged criminals, criminal enemies in play, hunted.
Oh, there is one. Case. I read it the other way.
If there are one or more unengaged criminal enemies in play, each of them moves one location towards you. Each criminal enemy that engages you as a result of this effect makes an immediate attack. I'll take some damage.
No, he moves here, but he's aloof, right? So he'll ignore us.
All right, yeah, I guess.
So like, this guy is basically just scouting the area.
Yeah, he's like, who
he's a pit boss.
Cool. And I get this one. Twist of Fate. No, I'm going to take some damage on it.
Reveal. No, you'll get a positive. Because I don't think this counts as a test.
No.
This is just revealing a
token. No, but like, there's one. Zero is a positive number, though. Yeah. No, I'll take damage.
Yeah. And I will get... Boom. Ooh. She's arousing suspicions. Place one Doom on each criminal enemy at your location.
That's not good.
Okay, I'm just I brought a dog in. It makes sense.
This is all your fault. You pull out your baseball bat. He's like, what are you doing?
Just playing with my dog. Each investigator checks hand size. Oh, we already did that.
Yeah,
each investigator takes a turn.
Yeah.
Does anyone want to go first?
Sure.
Yeah, go for it. I don't need the same one.
I can only move here because I don't want to be here anymore.
Yeah, you can move to the lounge.
Anyway, I'll go there.
Comfortable leather couches, mahogany furniture, and an array of beautiful art greets gamblers, tempting them into the life of the would-be affluent. While it is Act 1, Clover Club Lounge gains... Act 1 is like either of these, right?
This is Agenda.
Oh, Agenda, right, yeah. Discard an ally asset from your hand, gain 2 clues from the token pool. Limit once per game.
Push him under the box.
Dr. Armitage is a card in this expansion, but we don't have him yet. He's like a story reward, kind of.
0 clues, hey? All right. What else are we gonna do here? I guess I'll move to this one? Let's go to the card room.
The card room?
Yeah.
As you approach the card room, the clinking of poker chips and the shuffling of cards is punctuated by shouts of revelry and frustration. Your thoughts are nearly drowned out by the racket. While it is Act 1, Clover Club Card Room gains spend 2 resources, reveal a random chaos token. If it is the Elder Sign symbol, gain 2 clues and 2 resources from the token pool. If it is an even number, gain 2 clues from the token pool. If it is an odd number or a symbol, nothing happens. It's time to gamble.
All right.
I can cheat.
So I spend 2?
Yep.
And I got one of these.
Yep. We want an even number or the Elder Sign symbol. That, nothing happens.
Nothing happens, okay.
Unless you want to cheat. But like, let's not, are we that no,
I
desperate?
Think, I think we shouldn't. I feel like that's really bad if we cheat.
Mm-hmm. All right, I'm finished.
Okay, I'm going to move away from this guy. He's an asshole. One for two, we are going to...
Do you want to... Can you discard an ally?
No.
Get rid of Duke.
Place seeking answers. Investigate. If I succeed, instead of discovering a clue at my location, I discover a clue connecting location.
Seems good.
I'm going to fail, but whatever. Good.
Maybe.
So I have a 5 book?
Yeah.
All right, I can commit stuff.
It's 5 against 2.
He has to draw and draw.
Yeah,
again.
I believe in him, though. I believe in Rex.
Okay.
I'll commit Search for the Truth. I want to do this for an extra 3 book.
Nice.
So I got 7. Or 8. 8-2. It's worth knowing with this card, I use like this and this one Shroud.
Okay. Cool.
Not
good
that
to
it changes anything, but...
That's good to know. Minus two.
No, that's fine. I succeed, so I'll...
Put it back in, draw another one.
Try again.
You could spend two resources, though.
Turn it into a zero.
Turn it into a zero, so then you could draw a new one still.
I'll succeed.
Do you get an additional clue?
There's none at my location.
Cool. So we are 10 two. Away. 10 away.
Walk.
I'll come see what's going on in the bar.
Sure.
The shelves behind the bar sag beneath the weight of all manner of bootlegged drinks. Cheap ales, moonshine, expensive bottles of wine, aged whiskey. Only you had a couple hours to kill. While as Act 1, Clover Club Bar gains action, spend two resources, gain two clues from the token pool, and draw two cards. Remember that you had a drink. Limit once per game.
Huh? Can we wait to see what happens when you have a drink? Lose one action.
Yeah.
What a nightmare. Okay, so I feel like I'm gonna go 1-2. And we're gonna spend two resources to gamble.
Roll the dice.
Roll the RTD. Boom! Even number? If it's an even number, gain two clues.
Nice.
This place sucks. I can't report properly.
No, this is all a legal report. This is how Ash Can Pete reports. That's it for me.
With a baseball bat and a dog.
It's true. It's the truth. End of round. Enemy phase. So I guess this guy, he still will move. He just won't
engage anyone.
Yeah.
Reset everything. Ready your guys, untap your cards, get a resource, draw a card. Pew!
I don't like this guy. He's a jerk.
He is a jerk.
He comes and he sees you gambling and he's like, oh, they're winning, and he puts his hand on your shoulder, but it hurts and you take two damage.
Oh no, it's fine. He's just gonna come hang out at the bar with me.
Yeah. It's true. These cards?
That guy's got glasses. Oh,
yeah, placed one sketchy. Doom on the agenda, so we're currently at 3.
Go first player. Is that one Surge?
Obhanan's Thug.
Nope.
While he's engaged with me, I cannot gain resources.
He doesn't engage you, he's aloof.
Oh, that's right. He just shows up.
Okay. But I'd like
these
to
rats, him. Though.
Oh, there's rats in the bar!
Oh, God.
That's okay.
Another Obannon thug. I'll just like. They're all gambling here.
They want to make sure you're not counting cards.
Yeah.
I mean, maybe you should put your baseball bat away.
Maybe they should understand that in my day I was a major league hitter. And then it's all good.
Hey, Bryn, you're up.
Right, I'm going to play some Liquid Courage, which is just whiskey.
Yep, just whiskey.
What else are we gonna do?
Gamble your life away.
Way too many cards here.
I don't know how I'm gonna beat these rats. I don't think I can.
They only have one fight then.
I have two fight, and Rex is cursed. I'm cursed.
You'll probably get there.
I mean, it's a good thing I don't have anything else to do.
I could come before you and hit them with my baseball bat.
I mean, it's fine. I'm not gonna drink at the bar.
You should drink at the bar.
Why?
We just gotta get clues. It gives you two clues and two cards.
Oh, yeah, maybe I will. Yeah. But after I kill these rats.
Yeah, do you want me to kill them or do you want to do
it? I'll do it.
I'll spend two to gamble here.
You're super good at gambling.
It's gamble.
You get to gamble for free every turn.
Nope.
Good, I got happens. The same one again.
Yeah.
That's Wrecked. Cool. All right, I got one left. I'll gain a money.
All right, I'm gonna punch these rats.
Good luck, Rex.
Get them off me.
Two to their one.
Nope.
I'll draw a card.
Oh yeah. Means you're done with this.
No, I have to fail because of this effect. Oh, so I have to pass then fail.
And they only deal damage back on a retaliate, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
I'll punch the rats again.
Yeah.
Punch the rats.
one more time.
Take damage. I'm gonna die to these rats.
Yeah. They're fucking eating me! They're eating me!
Yep, nope, fail. This is good.
What kind of establishment is this?
Alright, we're gonna start by...
This is awful.
Gaining 3 resources. And if there's one thing Ashcan Pete knows, it's how to gamble resources away.
It's how to piss away everything he's ever made.
Let's go. Even number. That's an even number. And a little bit of the Crown Royale bag. Mm-hmm. So I'll gain 2 of these.
Some fuzz.
And let's do that one more time.
I was supposed to be the clue guy.
Don't worry, I know how to gamble. Yeah. Nope, nothing happens.
It's just, is this something for odd?
If it's an odd number or one of the symbols, okay. Something happens, yeah. End of round. How many do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
6.
We're halfway there.
Yep. Anyway, these rats hit me. This guy comes to visit me.
He's like, what are you doing over here? And you're like, oh god, get him off me. And he's like, nothing, I see.
Like, it makes sense. I'm like, trying to stomp on these rats on the floor, and you're just like...
We all gain a money and draw a card.
This asshole try to kill my pet rats.
Oh no. Darkest timeline.
You think you're in a dark timeline?
Probably.
The tide of these rats.
I can come in with my bats.
We're gonna do this. This guy's gonna like engage and kick the shit out of me.
So what if I come into your location, beat the rats off of you, and you come here and grab this clue?
Oh, that'd be pretty cool.
I think that's what we should do.
I'd like
to
fail getting that clue first, though.
That's fine.
I think to get rid of this curse.
Shall we do Mythos Phase? Doom on the agenda, this advances?
Yep.
Oh yeah, it does. That's probably not good.
This boss.
Your questioning has drawn the attention of several men, hired thugs by the look of them. Francis doesn't want to be bothered, one of them says. We suggest you leave the premises before we force you to leave. Shuffle the encounter discard pile into the deck. If the players have completed extracurricular activity, advances directly to Agenda 2B. If the house always wins is the first scenario in the campaign, advance to Agenda 2A.
2A this. Underground muscle. Most of the other patrons seem oblivious to the mobsters and goons closing in around you, but you recognize this for what it really is. You're about to get roughed up.
I read that right, right?
Yeah.
Cool.
Yes, these guys lose the loot. They're all gonna engage us now. Justin, you need to come kill this pit boss. I don't care about the rats anymore.
I wouldn't mind if you could kill one of these guys with your baseball bat.
Okay.
Sick your dog on this guy, though.
He's got 4 health. So hypothetically, if I were to double the difficulty on this, it would double this number, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Double or nothing!
Just
now we draw cards.
Yeah.
Hunted down. Revelation, if there are no unengaged criminals in play, I would like search, please. Place 1 doom on each criminal enemy at your location. Oh my god.
Can I have the rule book real quick?
Like, what if we could, like...
We're already at 3 doom.
Kill these guys.
Here you go, Travis, for when you're ready. Mm-hmm. It's probably going to be more rats.
I wish I had a weapon. And not just, like, you know, liquor.
Yep. It seems good, though, to deal with these guys. The only problem is you need to deal more damage.
Yeah, like with the baseball bat.
Yep.
Yeah, this guy, it puts 1 on each one in play, is what you did, right?
1 in his location.
Each 1 on my location.
Okay. When the agenda advances, any doing those on guys in play gets removed as well.
Beautiful. Okay.
So, like, they're not doing that bad. I have a mobster. I'm gonna die. Like, just, you have to kill these or I die this turn.
Twist of fate, reveal a random token from the bag, the mystery!
This is awful.
I take one damage. Okay, so here's the sitch. Here's the sitch.
You need to kill one of these, Justin.
Yes. Yes, I do, don't I?
Please.
I could probably do it.
I can help if I go. Ooh. When this guy spawns, I have a thing to do.
Cool.
I think I'm on my feet.
I hear board games are for nerds. Hell yeah, they are. Nice. Okay, so that's good. Are you? You're still in a stressful situation.
Yeah, I'll go to one heart.
Seems
but
bad.
Like you need to spend one less action getting to me now, so you could like hit Bryn's guy, move here, and hit one of mine.
Yeah.
I could actually come visit you guys.
Could you?
If I went first, yeah.
I mean, like you'd take a bunch of damage.
No, I wouldn't.
I think then you should go first because then I have three actions to hit with.
Yeah, that sounds right.
All right.
Okay. I'm gonna play shortcut. Choose an investigator at my location, move that investigator to a connecting location. It's fast, so it doesn't count as an action.
Nice.
Told you.
You do. Yes, you do. If you're a nerd, you belong here. If you're a bird,
then maybe not.
Yeah, maybe not. Maybe this isn't the place. Go back in your cage.
These rats.
You're gonna fuck up these rats?
Mind over matter. I could use my book instead of my punch and my foot this turn.
Yeah, kill these rats.
Yeah!
Your curse still wrecks, so don't get too excited.
I have three actions to kill these rats, man. Like
well, like two, right?
No, these are both fast.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
So we have rats. No way to get clues, do we?
Minus two. Rex curse.
We have to continue gambling.
But like killing all these guys.
But we gotta like murder a bunch of people first.
Oh, yeah. These rats are fucking dead.
Oh yeah, well it's one act 1A, yeah.
I still have to keep Rex's curse, so that's good. We're gonna punch this pit boss while we're here, I guess.
Yeah, you still use mind over matter?
I got a perception for you.
Nice.
That's sick. I'm working a hunch.
Justin just like me.
So okay, I don't want to play that one for this one. I'll use it for
my
next.
I want to play this because I have 8 cards in my hand and no real possibility of playing any of them.
Okay.
So I don't.
So what are you at for your?
I'm at 6 right now.
6 versus 4.
He's 6 versus 3.
3? Okay.
I'm probably okay for this.
Yeah,
one.
You're okay.
And I'm gonna save mine, use it for my next punch. That's a tie, which is in my favor.
Yeah.
Rex curse.
Come on, Rex.
Oh yeah, punch him.
I draw a card.
Yep.
So I still have 8. God damn it.
Want me to fail?
Yes.
We're going to punch him again and commit this working a hunch for 2 extra. So he got 6 to his 3 again.
Nice.
I get to draw so many tokens.
Nice.
Rex is cursed. Yeah. Let's roll.
He did it.
Amazing. Yeah, I'm done.
Nice.
All
right, Bryn, do you want to go before me or do you want me to go before you?
I wouldn't mind because you can kill these in one hit with the baseball
bat. Yeah, if I hit them.
Or kill this. Either way.
I'm going to kill...
I can help you hit one of them. I'd rather not take 4 damage if that can be avoided.
Yeah.
If it can't, then I guess that's how it is.
All right, let's start. I'm going to first go with one of these thugs.
This is a stream for nerds.
Okay. I could help you out with that.
What I'm going to do is... I guess it doesn't matter because I'm starting with both... 4 for each of them, but this is the one. They both kill them if they hit. So we'll use the baseball bat.
Sure.
You want to help me?
Sure. I got an overpower.
Oh, seems good.
Man, that turn was amazing. That's like the most competent in combat ever playing this game on stream.
All right, so I have 6 to their 4.
Incredible.
That's a -2, so
you pay resources,
he'll die.
So Bannon's thug down.
Yep.
I draw a card. Oh, there we go.
Discard baseball bat. It broke him.
You should sick Duke on this pit boss and see if we can kill him.
Sure. Well, I have 2 actions left, I guess. Yeah.
I could help you.
Like, Duke's probably good enough. He'll have
4.
Oh, 4 to 3, maybe, if you can help. That would be good.
Well, I can help myself.
Yeah, but we really want this guy to die. So
I agree.
2 hearts. He's also worth a victory point, so that's an experience at the end.
Yeah. No, I mean, I'm going to attack him. I'm just trying to think, because I have some... Expected courage. because we draw them all the time. Duke. Expected courage. So 6 to his 3.
I'll discard...
Well, if you look like get rid of cards, this isn't good use for it, because yeah, we want to...
Might as well.
7 to hits 3.
I don't really see too much that I would want to trade right now.
He's dead.
Ho, ho, ho. This idiot pit boss, he was like, I'm going to see what that guy with the glasses is doing. And then, like, his mobster showed up, and I ran away. And then I ran away again. And then, like, yeah, I turned around and started punching him. And then this dog mauls him.
You fucking break a baseball bat over that guy's head. One action remaining. I suppose I'm going to...
Man, we were ready to go.
Yeah. Yeah.
Bad cards, though.
I think I'm actually going to just start prepping for more gambling in the future. That'll be the resource.
Bryn can easily tank 2 hearts, so that's pretty okay. Oh, Bryn still has a turn.
I still get a turn.
Yeah. I think you could kill him, too. I can even help you. I guess. This is my...
Technically.
I can help with a knife. I mean, I wish my baseball bat didn't break.
Mm-hmm.
Is that guy tough?
No. He's got retaliate, and after he hits you, you lose a resource, but he's got, like, he's two across the board.
Duke will just eat his soul.
Yeah?
Yeah. Probably. That's what Duke does.
Alright, yeah, I guess I'm just gonna, like, base attack this guy. I have 3, he has 4, so I'm probably not gonna get there.
Can you do this after it's revealed?
No. I think I have to do that before.
Yeah.
I don't want to.
Okay, oh, you wanna fail?
Sure. I mean, like, there's no penalty to it, and I'm not going to do anything else.
You can try to evade.
I'm at 3 on evade.
Yeah?
We can give him, like, judgy when he readies.
Yeah. Okay, I'll try to evade him instead. That's probably much more likely to actually help.
Yeah, and then I think we'll just...
-1. Okay, so we got there.
That's good. And you can do other things this turn.
2 other things. 2 other things.
Go gambling.
Give me some money.
Oh, my God, Bryn.
I need it for things.
Gambling. End the turn.
Yeah.
Or no, that they get their turn. Like, this guy stays here, he readies and attaches to one of us.
I'll take him.
Okay.
Because Duke's ready to fight.
Ready all our garbage. Get a money, draw a card, check your hand size.
Uh-oh. Those don't help at all.
Doom on the agenda.
2 doom.
Yeah, this guy, he's probably gonna die, so... and then we each get a do.
There's something in the drinks.
Surge.
Give me that one. Place 1 doom on each criminal enemy at your location. If no doom was placed by this effect, lose 2 resources, but there is a criminal enemy at my location.
I'm cursed harder.
Good, I think.
Curse luck.
Hey.
Put a curse leg into your threat area, you get -1 skill value during skill test. After you succeed at a skill test by 1 or more, discard curse lock. Great. Just fucking great. Okay.
Okay.
I don't know what you're complaining about, Justin. I have to succeed like twice.
You do. Yeah. But you've done your thing. Now all you gotta do is gamble. Who wants to go first? Should I go first just in case I fuck up killing this guy?
Yeah, probably. We should have you go before Bryn at least.
Sure, yeah. I can probably kill him.
Right now? Do you want to shoot me?
Like, on his turn.
Yeah, no, I'll shoot you too.
What?
What's the timer for the gold d20, Justin?
15 minutes.
Azathoth doesn't like you.
Meaningless internet points, though.
Can anyone help me with this? Because I'll have 3 to his 4.
Absolutely not.
Cool.
Okay, I mean, like, technically.
Yeah.
It won't net help you.
I'm scared. What he means by that.
I mean, like, I can discard a card to give you plus a fight, but it doesn't actually help.
Yeah.
It makes it worse.
It makes it worse overall.
I guess I gotta hope for a +1, don't I?
I guess, like, I could throw away this one instead.
Well, let's go. Let's swing in with Duke. Yeah.
Yeah, I got a fire axe I can discard for plus one.
Okay. And in that case, I'm gonna also use this knife.
It's a good thing we came to this speaking just, just loaded with weapons.
He's dead.
Good stuff. Even including your minus one?
Yes, because
you win by more.
I was at three and we are at five. It goes to four. I did not win by than one. By one or more? No, I tied, so.
Yeah.
I'm still curse locked, but that guy's dead.
Man, this clue. I didn't spend so much time
trying to get it. Let's go gambling. Yes, more money, please! Well, I only drew one. I drew two because I was so excited to gamble. Oh! Winner, winner, chicken dinner!
So you got seven, though?
Yes.
I got one. You got eight?
I'm gonna draw a card.
Alright, I'm gonna spend a whole bunch of money on a thing here.
Oh, is it your gun?
Yeah. I'm gonna spend seven on it, I think.
Nice.
Because then I can use it forever.
Jenny is a twin of 45.
She's fucking ready.
She is.
What's your sister's name? Nellie or Nessie?
Izzy.
Izzy? Izzy? Yeah.
I'm gonna spend two to gamble.
Gamble? Nice.
Zero is an even number.
Boom! Boom!
So we're on 10, we need two more?
Yep.
Okay, worth noting when we do it, we immediately flip.
Sure.
I think that's good though, right?
Maybe.
Maybe? Maybe
it's I would like to clear up these curses before we get there.
I'm gonna be doing it next. You have until next turn because I'm gonna be trying again next turn.
I'm gonna shoot that mobster, I guess.
Yeah, we're gonna investigate. Clue bag, please. Come on. So five. Zero. Rex's curse. This is awful. Yep. I hate it.
You could fail to draw three cards and get rid of this. Or you could pass.
I could fail to draw four cards.
You'd get rid of this?
Yeah.
I'm going to choose to fail and draw four cards and get rid of my curse.
Okay.
So, they're all my effects. I get to choose what order to stack them in, right?
Yeah.
I mean, that would make sense to me.
I think that's a little bit better.
Yeah, I think so as well. Because this one's kind of soft. Mm-hmm. It's a lot softer than the other one. And I feel like we can still... I'd rather have this one gone for the next stage.
Yeah. Oh, I didn't hit any other bad things. Sick. My hand's full. It feels good.
Awesome.
Feels good. I'm not cursed.
Well, you still are.
I mean, like, I'm less cursed.
Yeah, still bad, though. And around?
Yep.
This guy stays here and parties.
Yep. Doesn't do anything.
Get some money.
Refresh our garbage.
Draw a card.
There we go. That's a good card.
I'm still be running away sometimes. Doom on the thing.
Doom on the thing. We're at two.
Yep. Let's have some new cards. Here you go.
There's something in the drinks. Give me the next one.
Man, good thing we didn't have a drink.
Ooh, I'm cursed.
We all have cursed luck.
Ugh. Ooh, reveal a random token from the bag! Boom! Take damage.
I'm not gonna lie, this one, it might be just because we were so well equipped to kill the enemies that showed up, but this one's a lot of fun.
This one is very fun. It's very flavorful, too. I feel like we're in a speakeasy. Gambling, yeah. All right. So, we're gonna flip this turn, right? You feel comfortable?
Probably.
We can help you with this guy?
I can run the fuck away from him.
Cool. Does anyone want to go first, or should we go back to just the standard?
I mean, I was just gonna go kill this guy and try to get rid of my cursed luck.
Sure.
Okay, but what if you came here and killed this guy?
Oh, man. Like, he's gotta feel like he's doing something, too. He's got this lead pipe, like, when we let him crack you with it one time.
Bryn, please.
I can't even get there.
Yeah, you can.
It'll cost me two actions.
Oh, you can go directly between these two. Yeah, okay. That's fair.
I'm fine.
I spent a card earlier. I didn't have to.
Yep. Whatever. I was also thinking the same
thing. We're gonna try to shoot him and we're gonna drink while we do it.
Nice.
Because everyone knows that makes you better at shooting Travis in the face.
Yeah. Don't miss. That feels so good.
Minus one, so I've got 3, 4, 5, 4, 5.
Yep, he's dead, and your cursed luck is no more. Because he deals plus one damage, right?
Yeah, it does plus one damage.
Thank you, friend.
Because apparently, you know, like, bullets are good or something.
Alright, those are Bryn's three actions?
That's what I got.
Okay.
Speakeasy. Speakeasy.
Speakeasy.
I want to do this without cheating.
Like, we can probably manage that.
Yeah.
So you guys think we're going to have to keep gambling to get clues? Or is it going to be like real investigating to be done?
How about I go before you? Because I can be here and try it first. And then you can adapt to what happens.
Yeah, sure.
Sure.
That sounds good.
Yeah. All right, let's get an even number. No whammies, no whammies. Minus three is a whammy. So I'm going to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm just sitting here gambling my life away. Grab one, draw a card. Oh, shit! I guess this is my only asset.
No, that one's an asset too.
Asset's a super type. It just doesn't
do anything. Yeah.
Cool. Oh, this is really soft.
This exhausts to be used, right?
No.
No, it's a reaction.
No, but it's after doing
that. Oh, exhaust pickpocket. Yeah.
That's why you just keep turning in the circle.
Yep. This is actually really soft right now.
Yeah, okay. For my turn, I'm gonna. Go laboratory assistant.
Sacrifice her. Nope. What does this mean? Are we selling them?
Yeah.
For information?
Here, you want to own this person?
Yeah, wait, what?
would you like to own Petey Sylvester? This broad-shouldered young man exudes the sort of confidence one only finds in youth, is what I will say as I try to sell him away.
For two, I'm going to go investigating.
Oh man, I could help you on that.
I don't need your help. Minus one. Yeah, I would totally succeed, so...
Oh, you don't have that one anymore.
I can give you my other succeed. Oh man, that's amazing. I didn't even want to really succeed in... Didn't matter.
So we're one away, right?
Yeah.
I have two, so I got two. Four plus your eight. You got eight, right?
I have seven.
Seven. So we need one more and we'll be left with one.
Mm-hmm. I'll take three money.
Seems good.
Yeah. Do I want to do that?
Maybe.
No, I think I want to move in here instead. So I can go, like, anywhere.
Yeah. Go have a drink.
I guess a little bear. Yeah.
Go have a drink. Fight this guy. I'm not scared
of
you.
Yeah, turn ends. Whack.
Blair.
There it is.
Whatever.
This is my life.
This is my life.
Yeah.
This is what I signed up for.
This is what you signed up for.
Oh, we're going to advance this guy.
Yeah, it's fine.
This guy just parties over here. Boom, advance.
Yep. Oh, check your hand size.
Yep.
I just seven. Discard to eight. Right?
I have a billion.
That's what it says.
But that's fine.
I've got eight.
Yeah, you hear a crash from somewhere outside and screams of pain in the lounge. Oh, a terrible monstrosity smashes at the entrance of the club, crushing the stairwell and knocking over gangsters and patrons alike. Spawn a random enemy from the set-aside Hideous Abominations encounter set.
Okay, that sounds promising.
In the Clover Club lounge.
Fuck. I regret it.
Regrets.
He helps us, though. Agenda 3A. Amid the chaos and confusion, the strange abominations attack everyone in the club. Screams echo through the halls as the blood begins to spray. At the start of the enemy phase, discard each criminal enemy in the same location as an abomination enemy.
Okay, we also have some of the other things. Shuffle the rest of the encounter set, the set-aside Strike and Fear encounter set, and the encounter discard pile into the encounter deck. So these ones, right? And these guys come in too?
Mm-hmm.
Cool. And then, last but not least...
Sorry, so, you know, you keep reading.
Move all investigators and unengaged enemies from the Labella Luna to the Clover Club Lounge.
Hey, friends.
Remove Labella Luna from the game.
Okay. No, I wanted to resign. Respond, resign.
Response.
Oh, yeah, and there's the little just beginning bit. So we just have a giant monstrosity that just walked in?
Maybe.
Boom! Oh, conglomeration of spheres. Shuffle them and shove them in.
Yeah. Conglomeration of spheres. That just looks real weird.
Hello, I'm from York
Soul. After you perform an attack against the thing using a melee card, discard that card. Oh, okay. Don't worry about it. I have guns. I'm gonna fuck this guy up so hard.
And where does he spawn? Oh, in here.
Oh man, you know what I forgot to put in this
Prey, lowest intelligence.
That's probably...
You guys are tied.
I'll take it.
Please? If you don't mind.
What the heck? This guy's super soft.
If you want to run away, I got you.
If I want to run away, I also got
you. He's got 6 health, though.
Yeah, but he's like... His one strength is like... He's just a ball of spheres. Yeah. As they say.
He's whatever.
He's dust.
He's dirt. He's dust.
I'm gonna kill him.
Good.
I believe in you.
Like this time.
Yeah. Fuck yeah.
That's the plan.
You're gonna do it? That's the greatest thing in the world. I've never thought you were cooler than this moment. Just blah, blah.
Look out, look out.
Continue the rest of this. It's so funny. He just kills the criminals. Blah. Everyone draw one of these. Bryn.
Oh, it's an abandoned thug.
I got rats.
Have a problem here? Like, probably. There's a bunch of
Can
spheres.
I have 2 cursed lux?
Yep.
Oh.
Why wouldn't you be able to?
You know, it's a question that I was hoping would have a different answer. I was just hoping more so for, you know.
I'm not the most cursed person.
It's because I've been gambling.
It is.
My shit does not...
It'd be cool if we could advance past the first act before we lose, though.
We're not going to lose. We're doing great.
We are doing great.
We've won a ton of our games.
I'm going to start to gamble.
Whatever.
Guys, is it time for us to cheat?
You don't want to cheat.
I think you just lose, right?
It's just one it's just ones. Nothing happens.
Like, maybe you just do your act by nightmares.
Sure.
Just get rid of that.
Already at the end of the turn. That's it for me.
So you can actually fight things.
All right.
Bryn's gonna fight guys this turn. I'm gonna kill these rats.
All right, so it's my turn to draw a red one because I've got more than one card to apply here. And that's how that works.
Yep.
I'm gonna fail to kill these rats.
Anyway, I'm gonna use the twin 45s to shoot at this conglomeration of spheres. I'm gonna pay 1 resource to get +1 fight. I'm gonna double or nothing.
Because he's gonna fucking blow.
This is the time to do it! That's amazing!
I could discard more cards, but I think I'm already at, like, I'm at what, 2, 3,
that's so good. 4. Against them.
I got 7.
Oh, yes!
And this is what you said was gonna be broken. 7?
Yeah.
This is probably where that is.
Yeah.
So I've got 7 to its current 2 because it's a double or nothing. I could throw away more cards, but, like, what's the biggest minus we're playing with that's not the red one?
-4. 4?
-4, okay, so I still win on that, so there's not much point in throwing away more
cards. Yeah, I think you just have to hope to not draw red.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You're using guns, right?
I'm using guns.
Okay, good.
Blacow.
Takes like 4?
It takes 4, because I succeed twice.
Gangsters are cannon. That is so fucking sick. This is why I'm so excited for new cards, too, because, you know,
things. Right.
Well, we're going to do that again.
You can spend your entire turn killing this guy and... Oh, no, you can't. If you kill this guy, you gotta kill this guy, too.
What? No, I don't.
I mean, like, you don't have to. You could just take 2.
Yeah.
But... Okay. You've taken no damage, yeah.
So I've got 4, 5, 6 against its 1.
Yeah, seems good. Once again, only the red fails for you. Yeah. Draw the cultist. Because you gain 3.
I'll take -2.
Yep.
Yeah, whatever. Kill this guy. He's out. He's done.
He's done. He's dust. He's
dust.
I just imagine everyone gambling and all of a sudden just this ball of spheres rolls into the bar and this lady just shoots it twice.
Like,
and just,
yeah, whatever.
And this guy should be like thankful. He should be like, okay, you win this one.
I'm gonna go to the bar with my other friends. and just stay
there. Alright, I guess I'm gonna shoot this guy too.
Can we actually, yeah, no, that's good. I was gonna say the other thing we could do is shoot the rats.
Oh, it's okay, he's gonna get the rats.
Oh, I was gonna say, but also then he could come here and try to gamble, just so we can...
No, I can fail killing these rats three foot zero.
So then we got, what, we'll go 1, 2, 3, 6.
When Netrunner? There's that new Netrunner coming out, the Legacy Netrunner.
Yep.
I think we'll just roll 6.
I want you two to play that on stream. I think that would be really cool.
I think we'd enjoy it. From what I can tell,
-2 from the things. So then we're tied, he dies.
Is like one person's like this hacker, and the other person's the corp. And you're trying to like balance the civilian's happiness with how much security you're enforcing on the city.
Nice.
I'm gonna punch these rats.
Let's have a miracle.
Oh, I'm gonna overpower these rats. But like only maybe. 4 to their 1, let's go.
Kill them. Oh, you have to redraw it.
Like, redraw
I don't have to. Oh yeah, I do.
Yeah,
but can I use it to fail?
I think so.
I'm still gonna try and just like punch it. I'm just gonna punch these rats. Yeah.
Okay, rats down, I draw a card.
Do you wanna come gamble? We probably should pass this.
Yeah.
Cause like we have this area like pretty tight under control. Just 2 resources.
2 resources? I'm poor.
I'm poor too. I've been gambling with literally my shoes. Get a 2. Or get that Elder Sign again. Because then you also have to draw 2 cards.
Gambling with your shoes, but also...
That
like,
actually...
Is not what we want.
Is not what we want, yeah.
That's unfortunate, but...
Yeah, that sucks.
Just like beat that guy to death with your baseball bat and then took his shoes because you lost your shoes.
Alright, enemy's turn.
Nothing happens.
Like nothing. Refresh all our stuff.
Draw a card. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Oh, no.
On the plus side, if rats bombard you again, I can help.
Oh, actually, that doesn't matter at all.
How many?
10. Dude. I have to have max. This laboratory system holds 2 for me.
Sick.
What's the shroud on this one?
None of them are relevant.
3, they're 3. They're both 3, okay. I'm searching for Izzy, but she's playing cards.
God damn it, Jenny!
Doom?
Doom.
Oh, okay. I can't play assets or events. That's fine. Whatever.
Something that drinks, but no one drank. Twist of Fate.
Oh, Frozen in Fear.
Oh, that's a good one. I mean, like,
seems actually pretty solid. I can actually get through pretty easily. Right?
0 is positive.
Is it?
Yeah.
I mean, it's just
what the negative.
Similar positive number. Yeah.
All right.
All right. Let's do this. This turn.
Sure. I'm gonna search for Izzy. That's what I do here.
Very, very good job on your above and below tutorial video. So professional, so proud of you. Thank you, Chad. I'm gonna be making some more of those this week.
Come search for Izzy before like we gamble away our futures.
And I'm gonna use these 2 actions to investigate.
Sure.
So it's 3 against 3, so we'll make it 5.
Oh, is this a fucking...
This is a book. I'll make it 6 because I don't really need this flashlight.
Can I also help because I'm going to be discarding a card anyway?
You can have this man help you.
Look.
Oh, wow. Okay.
Because I'm going to have to discard a card anyway.
Red 1. Oh, -4. That,
so I mean, that like, cancels that out works. These 2 cards.
Right.
Yeah.
I've still got 5. Hey, Izzy, stop playing cards. You got to go home.
You actually don't find Izzy, and that's why you have to keep looking for her somewhere else.
Just discard this.
Yeah.
Someone's like, we found Izzy here.
No mental trauma for you.
No mental trauma. I draw a card because I committed a gut, or not a guts, perception to it.
Do you want to spend those, or do you want me to look first? Because it's going to take me 2 actions to do it, because I only have 1.
I'll do it.
Okay. I believe in you, Rex. They can't curse you here.
I mean,
which is kind of weird, but
yes. All right, so we got to keep 1. Do you want to keep 1 of yours?
I won't keep 1 because it actually benefits me.
Sure. Boom.
After speaking to a number of gamblers and servers, I'm beating the shit out of a ton of mobsters.
Oh, fuck this thing!
It seems as though Dr. Morgan had quite the run lately. Instead of cashing on his winnings, he was convinced to double down. He was last seen entering the guarded hall near the back of the card room. put this aside, Darkened Hall, into play. This agenda one. Oh my no.
Oh my no.
Act 2A. Skin games. Dr. Morgan is somewhere in the private section of the club where only VIPs and the club's managers are allowed.
No, I don't want
to
go in there.
If you are to find him, you're going to have to sneak or even fight your way in. Only investigators in the VIP area may spend the requisite number of clues as a group to advance. Two per player.
Let's move these up. All
right.
Okay, so that's not that bad. So we can't gamble anymore.
We can go to the Darkened Hall, though.
Yeah. You have two actions left?
Yeah, I will.
Yeah.
I'll go explore.
This guy just still hanging out here like, oh my god, I can't believe what just happened. There's so many spheres.
The door slams shut behind you. You stand in sudden silence. The area of the club is lonesome and devoid of warmth and color. Somehow, the spotless floor and walls seem more sinister than inviting. Going on an adventure, gonna pick a random doorway.
Oh, this is so cool. This is so fucking sick.
I'm going to this one. Art gallery.
Ooh.
Forced after you fail a skill test while investigating the art gallery, lose two resources. So three on there. That's my turn.
All right, so I mean, I want to kind of get my baseball bat. Oh, shit. I have a lot of shit on me, so I'm going to gain a resource. and I'm going to pay for another baseball bat. I always bring a spare. And then I have...
As long as you're here, I can help you with that one.
Cool.
I'm not sure how good it'll actually go. I guess you got four, so... So, like, two.
Oh, fuck, that's right. Oh, god, no.
If you have one to discard, we're probably good.
I can discard something. Then I'm gonna just grab a resource to get ready to be able to buy more stuff in the future, and I think... Have you already gone?
Yep. I found Izzy, but I
right, didn't. Right.
We just been
end of my turn.
Hey, Izzy, what are you playing? Oh, you're not Izzy.
We're gonna test Frozen in Fear. Mm-hmm. I'm gonna use this to put me back up to four.
Okay, I've got a guts for you.
Nice. I'm at six versus it's three. We are good. And I passed by more than one, so I no longer have my curse luck.
Everything.
That feels good.
Draw a card.
I wasn't supposed to wander off alone.
No,
that wasn't part of the plan.
Or we can both get there this turn.
Okay, good.
Yeah. Or we could just go down to other doors.
Yeah. Just like, what's in here?
Hello?
Sins one. Doom on the thing.
Doom on the thing. Oh, we all do our thing as well.
This is done for me.
See you later.
Just till the end of the turn. I got some more abandoned thugs. God damn it, do they not know when
to play? Can't play acid events.
We got ourselves a scary body!
In the card table.
It's probably Izzy.
Oh, fuck. Izzy. I think I'm just going to be okay with worst case scenario failing this one.
Worst case Ontario.
Oh, right. Fuck. That's a bad thing to fail by. That's two. I'm okay with that.
I got some liquor.
Yeah, this is... It's all good.
Like, I got these abandoned thugs that I need to die before I can give you any. Or you can just leave and I can get myself out of here.
Mm-hmm.
Get two of these and draw a card. I should have done that first.
I can hit that abandoned thugs. Because you're not being affected right now. Like, you're fine.
Yeah, right? I'm just going to investigate all the whole time.
Cool.
We're only going to lose resources from this once because that's all we have.
Beautiful. So do you want me to kill this guy?
I mean, like, if you want some of my whiskey, yeah, sure. Yeah. I mean, otherwise, like, if you go first and move somewhere else, I can also get there.
We are going to
leave this guy here.
We're going to use Duke to attack these abandoned thugs. And I am going to overpower them.
All right, I got a knife.
Nice. So I have seven to their four.
Don't get the negative four.
Boom. Negative one. They're dead. I will draw a card from my overpower. Oh, shit.
This game's so much easier when we don't just keep drawing the red one.
Turns out.
Then I'm going to gain a resource and spend a resource to bring out this young, supple boy who will join me on my team.
He's like the star athlete. He's like, I'm gonna follow this homeless man around.
Because I'm playing. Like, anyway,
I used to play in the big leagues.
Anyway, there's Wonderwall, and he's like, no, maybe.
Yeah. Okay. Here, have some whiskey.
Sure. What does it do?
Heal a supply. Now test your brains.
What?
You're drinking.
What am I testing it against?
Two.
Oh.
Oh, okay, discard a card at random. You forgot something.
Sure, not a problem at all.
Track too much.
Because it's just going to be my leather coat or this lucky. Damn, that sucks.
Yep.
I get two more.
Oh my god, Brent.
Anyway.
Force feed Justin some more whiskey.
I'm good. We get him drunk and then we pin the crimes on him.
I will gain one more money. I'll spend it. All for Leo DeLuca.
I mean, like, no one's not going to believe it was.
And then I'll use the extra action he gives me to move here.
Cool. I'm going to investigate.
You want to turn my mic off? Drugs.
So I got 5. So this place is 2. Yeah.
Yeah. That damn curse.
I'll succeed.
Can you grab an additional one? Or? Wait, 2 or 1?
I do get an additional one.
Beautiful.
That's so good.
That's really good.
I'll investigate again.
Yeah, put this -1 back. That's a good one. That's a good one that we want that one.
5, it's 2 again.
Your curse?
Yep.
There's swirls in my coffee. That means I'm cursed. -2.
Good, succeed again.
Nice.
I'm so good at this one specific thing.
This is this is a good deck you've built.
It does what I want.
You just slow down, you have to be more consistent. Yeah. End of turn?
Yep.
Enemies
don't do anything
because this guy's still just drinking. He's like,
resource and a card. I have 11 cards in my hand. Alright, discard this Dissonant Voices in another round.
Doom on this.
I probably don't need this flashlight, if I'm being honest.
I'll give Bryn a resource.
A card. And then these. Does Bryn have Surge? No, he's frozen in fear. Something in the drinks for me. No one drank.
That's not true. Hunted down. Judge, you did. He drank some of the whiskey I had in the flask.
We have to give you a card and a resource as well.
I get 2.
There's the Surge on that or no? Oh yeah, from how do you gain 2?
It's my passive.
That's amazing. Hunted down. So this guy's gonna like move here because that's closer to me and engage to Bryn.
Oh, thank you.
I lose 2 resources.
I'm just giving you things to do, Bryn.
Oh, that's cool.
So, how about...
I'm going to explore a different...
You go to a different location, and if there's like a bad guy in it, I'll come join you. If there isn't, I'll go to the third one.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah. And Bryn can fight that guy.
Bryn, I want you to go first to try and kill that guy, and then check out one of these. Because then I can go to the other one, and I may be able to like investigate other places.
I'll try to shoot him.
Okay.
This guy finally has gotten courage. This is essentially what just happened. He was like, I can do this.
He's dead.
Oh, this poor man. He's just a mobster.
Just a
poor innocent mobster.
So you have 1 action left.
Oh, you're frozen in fear. Hey?
Yeah.
Oh, that's bad.
Come explore one of these places.
I mean, I've got 2 because I've got...
Oh, yeah, that's right. Leo DeLuca.
I'm like, yeah, sure.
We'll flip. That's what we need to do.
Back hall doorway. You approach an unmarked door in the back of the Clover Club. It's the VIP area. While you are in the VIP area, you cannot draw cards or gain resources during the upkeep phase. It's 3, and there are 3 clues here. Okay. Sure, that's fine. I didn't need money anyway.
Check out the other place, then. Yep. Like, 1... use shortcut.
Nice.
So still a one. Then I'm gonna investigate.
We can resign. We can get up this way.
Oh, sick.
A steep narrow staircase ascends to a second unmarked door. To your surprise, leads to the back alley behind La Bella Luna. This must be where they smuggle in their quote-unquote goods.
Negative one. Try again for X's curse.
All right.
Fuck.
It's gone, though. The curse is gone.
Yeah, I get to draw a card off Rabbit's foot.
Nice.
Rabbit's food.
Okay, I'm just going to draw it again, like...
You have one more action?
Yeah, I'm going to investigate again.
Yeah, because if you pass this, we pass this one, right?
Yep.
Yeah, because you'll get... Oh, if you pass by more than two. Which seems five. Very likely, yeah.
I could auto-fail! No, I'll do the thing.
That's enough to do this?
Yep.
Holy crap, where'd you get all those clues?
Every time he succeeds by two or more, he gets to draw two clues from the location.
Wow, okay, yeah, alright. Seems pretty okay.
You find Dr. Morgan gambling in one of the VIP rooms, but he appears to be playing cards with two unconscious bodies. His pupils dilate as though in a trance. He can't seem to stop laughing, smiling, and chatting with the other players. Put this set aside, Dr. Morgan, and play in the VIP area.
Hello, and Dr. Morgan.
Advance to all in. With or without Dr. Morgan, you have to get out of here fast. While Dr. Morgan is not controlled by a player, he gains action parley. Test brain 3 to shake him out of his daze. If you succeed, place one clue from the token bank on him. If there are one clue per investigator on Dr. Morgan, take control of him. Objective, if each undefeated investigator has resigned, advance.
Okay. Okay, you're done?
Yep.
So I'm going to go 1-2 and parlay with him.
Sure. With your brains?
Yeah, my brain 3. I feel like this is too slow to do anything with, but... I mean, like, we're in a pretty good position, so we're not in really...
I'm feeling pretty good about this.
Oh! Already, Duke!
It's so good.
Pass.
It's been so much easier when we draw the blue one on the front.
Oh, yeah, right. Sorry, at the end of my turn, I was supposed to test my brain through it.
Do you mind turning me off? I'm just going to go pee, and you can turn Bryn back on.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to discard Guts for this, because I don't want to... have this frozen in fear. I hate this card.
It's pretty rough.
Minus one. Okay, good. We're out.
Roped.
We're out, boys. Draw a card for that. Hey, that seems real hard to do.
Okay. Draw a card. Refresh our garbage.
I can't because I'm in the VIP.
I can't.
The VIP.
I'll discard working a hunch. I don't think I'll need to do that anymore. Oops. This gets refreshed. Justin gets a card and a resource. No, he doesn't.
He's in the VIP.
Okay. Do one thing. Here. Does that have surge?
No. Zero is positive, nothing happens.
I require your assistance.
Holy shit.
What the fuck is this?
That's worth victory points.
It's a servant to the lurker. It is worth victory points.
Wow.
Draw a card.
Yeah, I require your assistance.
May I see him as well?
Yeah.
It's pretty neato.
I could probably like run
burrito.
Away.
Wow.
Oh man, no, never mind. I'm thinking on my feet. Like, not really.
God damn it.
Hello, friends.
Can you do a small favor? Instead of going here, go here. So then he doesn't move in here where we have to talk with Doctor.
This is not a connecting location.
Okay, cool.
Hey, so Judgy.
Refractal Studios, thank you so much for the host. I really appreciate it. What's up?
Do you have things you could throw away to make your brain better?
I do.
Like a lot?
No, some. Some things.
Like more than one?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, because we could hypothetically get this done on the next shot.
On this next turn?
Yeah. I mean, like on this next one try.
Yeah? Oh! Double? I mean, no, like, I don't even know. I don't even know.
Are you a gambling
man? I don't have enough for that. No, I don't have enough.
It'll
for
make
that.
It six.
Here, Fractal Studios.
I can't help you with anything more than like the base value on that card.
Yeah. I mean, I can do it over two actions, like.
I think we won't do it this turn. Yeah. And then, like, they'll kill us.
Well, because like, what's your brain is three. My brain is the high. Like, I've one higher than you guys, so.
You should probably be the one to try to do it.
Sure.
Shit, that thing does a ton of damage, right?
Yeah. It'll fuck you up.
I will.
Resigning, is that an action that they attack you on, or can you resign? It's parlay. Know. I think it's like
I mean, like, it's not going to be there, right? It's going to move here.
Sure, I'm going to try to start talking to him. Let's start that off. Double or nothing! I mean, I think we want to do this, so I'm going to use this Dig Deep to give me up to 5. Because I don't think there's enough time to spend the resources to use that to my advantage. Yeah. Let's go again. Double or nothing!
There's no point now.
Let's do this Rabbit's Foot.
No, Resign doesn't. Proc.
Cool.
Attacks opportunity.
Cool.
Because you're just leaving.
Just passing over the tabletop, love. How's it going? It's going great. It's going great with Fractal Studios. This has probably been my favorite, apart from Carnival. This one's probably my
it's
favorite.
A lot of fun. I like it.
Minus two. So it's, I have 5 versus the 3, so we have parlayed with him.
Okay. He's under your control. Please don't kill him.
So does that mean you have to ditch this?
Yep.
Whatever young man you said.
Yep.
Okay. Did you turn my mic back on, Travis? I just thought of that.
So then my last action, I move here to get ready to resign next turn. That's the hope?
Yep.
Yep.
No, man, we want to kill this thing.
I mean, we do. We get an extra experience for it. We get
a point I will it. Resign just because I want him to live.
Why are we even a team?
Yep.
All right, so... He's gonna come into that room and engage one of us.
The lowest feat, which
yeah, which would be like we're all three, right?
Yeah.
So we get to pick.
Unless I don't come.
I used to have 4.
Yeah. Okay.
Used to have 4. Just kidding. I want this guy.
Like just.
All right.
Well, I mean, like, if he's in my graveyard, am I in control of him?
No.
No. He has to be alive.
He has to be alive.
Okay.
All right. I mean, like, I'll come out here. Can any of you help me buff my fight?
I can do a tiny, tiny little amount.
I mean, like, yeah.
So I'll draw a card. Because that puts me to 7. And I guess then I'll just gain 2 resources because there's not too much else to do. I could give Judgy some more whiskey, but he can't handle it.
He can't. It's too much. Too much whiskey.
So I'll just gain 2 money with the other, with the remaining actions and go from there.
I'll spend some cards in my hand. I'll, yeah, I guess. Actually, we're gonna go seeking answers.
This guy has a butt on his knee.
This guy's a knee butt.
We're gonna investigate this location.
Nice.
Why not investigate this one?
Because we want the victory points. We're not having any clues on here.
Oh, okay. I mean, isn't there this victory?
Yeah, but I'm not gonna get all those.
Yeah, but what if you go in there and do that?
No. Oh my god. It's 1?
Yep.
Okay, I did it. I have like 5. 2 will gain 3 resources. And 3 will just draw a card, I guess.
Why not go in there and try to investigate all the things?
No.
God damn it, Travis. You coward.
We have three whole turns. That's so
good. Everyone's done. Good.
Yep.
Flip all your stuff.
This guy moves in here.
I'll take him.
I got chronophobia.
So he's going to attack me, right?
Next turn he will.
Does he, like, he'll move towards me and then each engaged enemy
will attack, so he will attack first, yeah. This is the first damage you've taken?
Yeah. I think, I'm just going to tank it.
Yeah, you're fine.
I could, dump it onto Leo.
You could.
But I don't want to.
I'm a little concerned we're running out of time, though. I think we got around.
I guess we could.
If we exhaust him, I can do some good chunk of damage to him.
That's good.
So.
Maybe if Bryn wants to evade it.
I don't want to evade it.
But
I want to shoot him in the face.
But if he's evaded, I can deal a good chunk of damage to him.
Place one doom on each thing. If no doom was placed, lose two resources. Fine.
It was those two resources you got last turn, right?
Yeah, whatever.
Oh, fuck, rats!
So there's...
Me too.
There's no max to the number of cards I can discard for a test that I'm performing.
Right.
Okay.
Do you want to go first?
To go first.
Sure.
On that note. I guess I gain two of these and draw a card here.
Kill him, Bryn.
Okay, so this is going to be the one where I draw the red one because I'm going to shoot him with Jenny's twin 45s and I'm going to spend one for plus one. And I'm going to double or nothing. Like that?
I got one for you.
Because he's got eight. So.
So how much did you add to this? So
lots. I don't probably
one,
don't
two,
need
three,
guys.
Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14.
14 versus eight.
It's a minus one. Fuck you. Get styled.
So do you take four damage?
Take a bunch of damage.
Take a billion. Okay, well, we just all end on that play then, so.
Maybe try running away.
I can try to shoot him one more time because I've got another bullet.
Yeah, use your last bullet on him. If he's dead.
I can shoot him and then I can still try to run away because I've got four actions this turn, right? So I can run away and I can still move in there
resign,
if I want to. I can't resign if I shoot him and miss and have to run away.
That's
oh no, wait, I can. I totally can. If that's what Blake's card does.
Okay, do that then.
Yeah, fire on him.
So I'm going to shoot. I'll pay one for plus one off the hard knocks. I don't have any more cards to discard.
Can you do this multiple times?
Yep.
Yeah, but I need the rest to get away.
Oh, okay.
Three. Okay. So you got six to his
four?
I got
six to his four.
I can help you a little bit, too. I got the cyber ward. No, that doesn't do that. I don't have any fighting.
I mean, I can do this.
I guess, no, I can. I got this ward protection I can throw away for it.
And I'm just going to be plus one because we're not going to be evading this guy. I don't. Mm-hmm. Unless I keep this, just in case. Thoughts? Fuck it. That's good. I'm going to keep it.
We got seven to his four.
Minus one.
He's dead.
I don't want those.
Yes, you do. I'll tell you what you want.
And you can resign this turn, can't you?
I could resign this turn.
I think we should.
I think we want those clues.
No, I think we'd resign.
Yeah, I think we resign just because more things can pop up.
Fine.
Right, so there's still one more.
Move here and then resign because I get an extra action with Leo.
And we can walk away from these guys. They follow us, but we just take damage, right?
Yeah.
All right, I'm going to spend...
I'm just going to move. Yeah, we're both going to move in there, take damage, resign.
Resign, yeah, exactly that.
Good stuff, boys. You escape the club, doing your best to look inconspicuous as several cars pull up near the street. A handful of grim-faced men and women exit, running towards the restaurant's entrance to take control of the situation. One of them catches your eye, his hand on the grip of his .38, but thankfully he turns his attention back to the rest of his crew and follows them into the club. You breathe a sigh of relief. Where did I put the thing? Oh, it's over here. What in the world? Dr. Morgan finally breaks out of his daze as you make your way to safety. You ask him what he remembers, and he sputters and shakes his head. It's all a haze, he explains, visibly exhausted. I was having the run of my life. Perhaps I'd won too many shots. But those creatures...
I haven't seen
anything like that since. He trails off, and you can tell that his mind is racing.
They were foreshadowing.
His eyes widen with realization as his face pales. I may not be in the best shape, but I'll help you with your investigation, whatever it takes. Do you have a... Pass me a pad of paper?
Yeah, of course.
Rescued Morgan.
Mm-hmm.
O'Banion gang. has a bone to pick with us.
Yeah, well, we shot a bunch of their guys. Judgy killed one with a baseball. Killed a lot of them.
This is all true.
Stole his shoes.
If any player cheated, add one squid chaos token to the chaos bag for the end of the campaign, but we did not.
Nice.
Oh, nice call, Judgy, I guess.
Yep.
Anyone can add Francis Morgan to the deck. Doesn't count towards your deck size.
Plus one fight, and after you defeat an enemy, exhaust Dr. Francis Morgan to draw a card. I mean, like, one of us should take it, but you have better allies than I do.
Yeah, I've got, like, Leo DeLuca. He's so the one I always want.
I should take him, because then I can...
I mean, you've got the...
I would probably cut... I'd probably just run a one of him.
Sure.
Yeah.
All right, we have 4 experience for this one.
4?
Yep.
Okay.
And then proceed to scenario 1A.
Is there any... Yeah, okay, cool, that's it. All right, I'm going to just stop the recording. We're going to do the second one tonight, too.
Take us a minute to set up, but
yeah.